We are joined again by certified holistic health coach Heather Ferber, and today we're making a dish, as I mentioned, on a cool fall day. Should this warm the soul here.
Warm us up.
All right, what are we doing here?
So we talked a little bit about anti-cancer foods. Cauliflower is a member of the cruciferous vegetable family, and they've been well-known, well-documented to help in fighting cancer and in preventing cancer. So we're going to make some cauliflower soup.
Okay.
This is easy. What I like to do is start with a baked potato. I just bake this in my oven and peel it so that it's all ready to go. You take a little bit of olive oil. You want to have your heat, your stove on, like medium heat. You're going to do a little sauteing of some of the vegetables.
The heat on there.
There you go. I can feel it sizzling. I like, my personal taste buds love a lot of onions and leeks. You can adjust these if you don't, though. So we put a little onion in, we put a few leeks in, and you're going to saute these for just a couple minutes until they soften. Then what you want to do, this is approximately this, one head of cauliflower, a small head of cauliflower.
And those are raw.
Raw. Okay. Yep, none of this is cooked. The only thing cooked to this point is the potatoes. I just pre-cook those to make it easy to peel. And you're going to put all of that into your pot.
Okay.
And just kind of saute things again until they're coated with the olive oil.
Show them all in there.
Everything kinda there.
Okay.
Until it gets a little, just everything is slightly softened. And then you have your options for what type of broth you'd like to use. I use usually about half of chicken or some organic chicken broth and half water. You put that, you add that into your pot. This is about 3 cups of liquid here. If you don't like your soup quite as thick, you can add just an additional cup of water, and then when you blend it, it'll be a little bit thinner. And then you're going to cook this for about 10, 15 minutes, just until your cauliflower softens. Now, what I brought today for the studio to make things easy is what you cook here, you are going to take and either put in your blender or put in your food processor, and you can even use a hand immersion blender with this combination. You don't need to have a fancy blender.
Right. All right.
So we are going to
whip
this on, the switch.
Closed here.
The lid is on tight.
Right.
It only takes a couple seconds.
So it has kind of a white kind of, you know,
it does.
I guess it is cauliflower. So
white, it's thick,
it's, nice.
It's pretty velvety. Now you could add whatever flavors you like to this, but beware that your soup will also turn that color. If you add greens to this, your soup will be green.
Okay.
But you can be creative. And then what I like to do is just add a couple of toppings. This is some curried quinoa. It's basically quinoa prepared.
Everybody is eating this right now.
One of the ancient grains, high in protein. Nice alternative to rice. Great flavor.
Sure.
You just put the curry powder in your water when you're cooking it.
Okay.
And a few little extra scallions.
Wow.
Maybe some pepitas. And a little bit of fresh parsley.
Wow.
And you have a wonderfully warm, amazing, hot anti-cancer fighting soup.
Wow, there you go, because it is October, National Breast Cancer Awareness Month, so that's a food that's good not only for to keep you warm, but to maybe make you stay healthy. So, all right, Heather, thanks so much. And anyone who wants to learn more about healthy living, they can just go to Heather's website, and that is betterhealthbyheather.com. We've also posted that link on our website, wisn.com.